My name is Devanand Nath and I'm a doctor by profession. Then I learned filmmaking and I started my film studio at Panvel and a film institute at Andhra.
So Darshan Kanani, I'm from Sankalp Organics, that's into organic food business.
I'm Venugopal, my company name is Vishal Organics, we are into herbal product manufacturing.
I'm Sanket. I'm a startup. I've just got into corporate catering in the name of Urban Spice Corporate Catering.
Mayank Agarwal, VN2 Stainless Steel.
Anil Pais from Hosham CM. Traditionally, we are doing logistics, but the company that I'm representing here is Falafel Sandwich. It's a new venture. It's a Lebanese food cuisine which we have just started.
I'm Andrea Silva. I help my husband, Vincent Silva. He has his own management development and training and consultancy firm.
My name is Harpreet. I just completed with my management studies this year and I aspire to be an entrepreneur.
I'm Lavin Nikshunari. I look at web initiatives with Time Mobile.
I'm Akshay. We are an iPhone member of Lux Concept.
Great. So now I invite Prajit to share his entrepreneurial.
Okay. To begin with, good morning to everybody. And you know, to sort of set the record straight, he and Messi are both actually in the same business. We are both in the food business. It's just that he's at the beginning of the food chain. I'm at the end of the food chain.
After we lived, I noticed that Harpreet, right? She's a management student, and I think we've been in the same side of the I've been in the same situation a few years ago. I was a management student as well, and I passed out from Symbiosis, and always wanted to do something different. The first thing that came to my mind was that I want to make a product which would cost only 1 rupee, that I could sell it to everybody in this country. So that's 1 billion people, and you can make that money time over again. Somehow it never happened. Subsequently, I was working with a company in North America for a short period, where I really realized that the real calling was not a product, but a service, which was a portable toilet service, because that was something which I could get closest to. And okay, I can charge a rupee to a person and he can utilize his toilet, and everybody in this country can get to use the toilet. So actually that's how I really started, and yes, entrepreneurship was very much on the agenda even while I was doing my MBA. So when I started about 12 years ago, in India the situation was not that it's much better now, but I guess we helped in some way get better. Situation sanitation was quite terrible, and we really didn't have too many people in this portable sanitation or unserved settlement space. So we decided that I started with 2 toilets. I said, okay, I would start selling these toilets. But, the polyethylene toilets were just so expensive that not anybody was willing to buy them. And by default, we really got into service because they were lying with me inventory. I had no money. I said, okay, what do? So my friend said, you know what, I've got a marriage hall and there's a wedding coming by. These toilets look very nice. Why don't you give them to me? I'll use them over the weekend and see how they are. So I said, sure, I'm going to get me, fetch me some money, why not? So I just moved them there and I gave them for 2 days. I got a little bit of money and I said, okay, you know what, I think this is better than just owning them and trying to sell them, because it's like selling toilets was a lot more difficult. So this concept sort of picked up, is to increase our number of toilets. And then we got into not just events, but we also got into construction subsequently. So we had Indian toilets which we designed construction requirement. Earlier we used to import all these toilets from Germany or the United States, and it was very, very expensive. Subsequently, we in 2006 we set up our own plant to manufacture similar kind of toilets polyethylene units. We tied up with companies abroad for technical collaboration. We got molds from there and things like that. And today also we continue to import some critical components for the quality and the appeal. Subsequently, we also moved into, as I said, into construction industry, and we are in almost 12 cities in India right now, where we have a full-fledged offices and yards, where you have these toilets and the entire staff. Now, what we do is a little different. We don't really sell toilets, or we don't really rent them, but we service them. The difference is that we clean the toilets. We ensure the hygiene of the toilet is optimal. So it's not really provided to them, just take money on rent. So we make sure that whenever we give you a toilet, it's absolutely clean, spick and span, and our team of people will come, they'll clean it, wash it, and we have a truck with a vacuum suction machine which will come and evacuate the toilet, which means the toilet has no need for any drain line connection. It does not need any mains free, it does not need